Forbes has been in existence since the 1900s. The Forbes list, or Forbes as a body, is bigger than anybody that has been there in the past decade. I'm talking not only the under 30 list, I'm talking about even the billionaires that have been on that list. You understand? This is an institution that's been there for a while. And then if you look at it, can we discredit the Forbes list? This, first of all, this is not even the first time that this kind of incident has happened on this cable. We're not going to talk about that. We're going to look at other things entirely. We're talking about, is it the first time this has happened? And secondly, is this a good enough because of this scale or this thing that happened on a very regional scale, on a small scale? Are we now going to say we're going to discredit the Forbes list? I don't think that's a probable cause to discredit the Forbes list. The Forbes list is always going to be here to stay. What we're going to look at is the society that has brought or celebrated such people. I mean, there's a lot of things there that we have to put into question. How did someone like this even get to the Forbes list in the first instance?
That's actually a question for you. So now that you've gotten into that question, I would ask you, it's a question for many Nigerians. How did he get in there? What are the criteria to even get into the Forbes list?
The first thing is, it's a very rigorous process. It's a process that I cannot expatiate right now, but I'll say it's a very vigorous, multi-layered process. And one very important part of this process is, apart from submitting your financial documents and whatever you say you have done, you have to submit your tax returns and your police report, a police report of showing you that you have been in good standing. So now, how does somebody with questionable finances, questionable business, how is he able to get tax returns? How is he able to get a police report of good standing? The problem is, it is these institutions that were supposed to have provided good, done their jobs to make sure that whoever they are vetoing for is not a questionable character. So I will still bring it back to the night. Leave Forbes out of it. Forbes was always going to do his own job of putting whoever is wealthy on the list and putting wealth creators and celebrating wealth creators to encourage the populace. So the problem is, who are the people that vetoed, or the organizations that were able to certify that this person is in good standing? The police, the tax, the FIRS, and so those are the places to look at. So it all.